and I hated this book. Hey guys, and welcome to another episode of All Things Diamond Snow. It's your girl, Diamond Snow. We are doing our April wrap-ups, and I know I'm a few days late, but we're here. I have my matcha and my dog, always, okay? A drink and a dog. So, April, do you want to come up here? Come. Because you have to sit. Sit. Okay. So, April was not the best reading month for me. I only read 3 books, but 3 is definitely better than none. So, let's get into it. The first book I read was Happy Place. And all 3 books that I've read this month have been on, well, through Libby. If you guys do not know about Libby, Libby is basically an online platform where you can link your library card. Coco stay. Libby is a okay, come, but you have to chill. Sit. Coco, please. Thank you. It's an app where you can basically link your library card and you have the whole catalog of the library. And there's different libraries out there in different states that you can get a free library card, so you have access to their library catalog as well. So it's an amazing platform, especially if you want to save money. Reading can be a very expensive hobby, and yeah. But all that to say, this month, which is May, I need the physical book, okay? Because it's something about having a physical book that I just love. I want to highlight, annotate, all that stuff. And that's the missing factor I think I had this month, in addition to taking a trip to Arizona and my grandma's 70th birthday. So there was a lot of people interaction I had this month, and it was hard to really read, but I had fun and I'm excited to see what May has in store. Again, the first book we have is Happy Place by Emily Henry. And I read that as an ebook on Libby, and it was amazing. That book took me a little bit to read because I felt like it was like divine timing on certain scenarios. Can you get down, please? Down. That they went over in the book. And throughout reading Happy Place, I feel like I was in multiple stages of my happy place. So when I was reading the book, I started CrossFit again, which is my happy place. Like, I just love that energy that CrossFit brings. I also started coaching again, softball, so that was fun, another happy place. And then my girlfriend and I and Coco took a trip to Dahlonega, which is another, happy place of mine. So I just felt like I gave that book, I don't even do a star rating, you know, I just do, I think you should read it, or I think you shouldn't waste your time. But that book was like 5 stars. It was so amazing. I cried so many times. Like, it was just very relatable, and I think the season that I'm in, like, that book just hit really hard. So there's the main character, and she's going on a trip to Maine, where her friend, okay, so it's like a vacation spot that her and her friends always take. Her and her partner broke up, but her friends don't know, and they basically try to keep it a secret, but then all the friends have their own secrets, and then like everybody just grew up. So, you know, life like that, and me being 27 and going through friend breakups and even like situational breakups, it was just easy for me to resonate with this book, and I just loved it so much. And I also downloaded a like a book little binder on Etsy where you basically have a book journal, I should say. And Happy Place was the first time I used the book journal. And when I tell you I filled out the crap of that book, let me see if I can find it. My entry, I didn't finish it. I mean, of course, 5 stars, but I hope you can see. I may get a little closer. This is my entry for Happy Place, and I just wrote so much, and I just love this book. Like, definitely 5 stars. I think you should read it. Emily Henry has a lot of books, and this is the first book that I read, but I heard Beach Reads was like one of her really good books, so I want to read that next. I just like the way the book made me feel, so definitely think you should read that book. Alrighty, book number 2. Again, this one was through the Libby app as well. Let's see. Yes. We Weren't Looking to Be Found. This was my next book, and I listened to this as an audio version on Libby. And I remember having this book. I don't remember where or when I picked it up, but I remember having this physical copy of this book. And then I read a little bit and I just didn't, you know, really like it. So I stopped reading it, and I don't even know where it is to this day, but I saw it on Libby and I was just like, let me try it. And it took me a minute to finish this book because it's like a YA, I guess you would say, like young adult, like two girls who weren't looking to be found. They go through their own trauma with the like family or their parents, and they both end up in a treatment center for ladies who are struggling with addiction. I listened to it and I think that's what made it like because the audio didn't match up. Like, it was dual point of view, but when the other person was talking, like the voice was completely different. It just made them sound super weird, so it was hard to get into. But once I got into the book, it was so good, and I even wrote down so many quotes from the book. And I think I just love books about mental health and how navigating on how parents throw their trauma onto kids and how kids basically interpret that trauma in the right way. Like, you know, whatever trauma is placed on you, you can react however you want to react, you know. So it's really up to people to really make sure before you have kids to make sure you are working on yourself, or you had time to work on yourself. But I don't want to get all into that. But basically, they're roommates and they help each other out of a situation. And they also find like some notes from someone who used to be in the same facility, and they kind of bond over that. But it takes forever to get to that point. And even though that's like on the bio, you think, okay, they're gonna find this stuff and like all that, but no, it's like the last hour they find it. So it's kind of like dragged out, you know, everything that they've been through and stuff. But anyways, I liked it. I think you should read it. Yeah, next book. This last book. Let me make sure. I'm so dramatic. Let me make sure I even have the title. Because one thing about me, I'll forget the title of a book. I listened to this on YouTube. The audio version on YouTube. And it is The Housemaid Secrets by Freda McFadden. And I hated this book. I read The Housemaid's Secret. Wait, it's two of them. Let's see. Okay, so there's The Housemaid and The Housemaid's Secrets. I read The Housemaid, which is the first book of the series, and it was pretty good. The ending made the book like 20 times better. So I was just like, okay, the second book is going to be pretty good too. I know it's going to have like a really like plot twisty. No, this book was predictable, dragged out. The main character was getting on my nerve. Like, I did not like this book, and everybody hypes it up. Coco, no. Everybody hypes it up, and again, this is why I do not do book talk. Like, the people don't know. But the book is predictable. The book is not good. It's dragged out. I think I gave it, again, I don't even do the star ratings, but I don't think you should read it. I don't think you should waste your time. If you need a book that's like in the mystery genre, I'm currently listening. Coco, sit down. Stay. I haven't done like a sit down reading, whatever, in my chair in a long time. And you guys know Coco is my reading partner, so I think he just wants to enjoy this moment with me, and I'm not paying him any attention, so. things we do in the dark. That is what I'm currently listening to on Libby, and like that is giving so much more mystery and great backstory. It's like I'm watching a freaking movie and I'm just soaking this book up. But anyways guys, that is all for my April reading wrap-ups. I know this video was very dysfunctional, but I promise to do better in May. Bye.